Hi, my name is Lina Rodriguez-Salamanca. I'm with the Plant and Insect Diagnostic Clinic, and today we're going to go through the steps to collect the proper sample to test for oak wilt. If you suspect that your oak tree may be suffering from oak wilt, be very aware that we need a specific sample in order to recover and test for this pathogen. So before you start, we recommend that you download our oak wilt sampling checklist from our website. Also, download our plant problem diagnosis form, so once you're in front of the tree, you can give us as many clues as possible. Have with you a camera or a smartphone. Make sure that you have a cooler. A styrofoam cooler works pretty good. Ice bags or ice. Bags, plastic bags. Ziplocs are a good idea. Cutters or a saw. Knife. Permanent marker, especially if you will be collecting samples from different trees. And a pen to fill out the plant problem diagnosis form. Something to consider too is if your tree is too big or the branches that have the symptoms are too high up, you may need the help of an arborist. Look at your tree, observe the symptoms. Particularly look for yellowing, bronzing, and browning of the leaves. But also look at the pattern on the tree. Are the symptoms occurring from the top of the tree down? Take some pictures of the tree from far, but also some close-ups. Approach your tree and select a leaving symptomatic branch. This means that you want the branch that you're gonna cut to have some green tissue. Completely dead branches are not good for testing. Cut your branch and strip the twigs from the branch so that there's no twigs attached. But do keep some twigs plus leaves and include some with the sample in the same cooler that you'll be packing the branches. Now, make sections of your branch that are about 6 to 12 inches in length, and also make sure that the branch is 1 inch in diameter, at least 1 inch in diameter. Place your branches in the cooler, and one by one, use a knife and look. Peel the bark of the branch, looking for staining on the sapwood. We need at least 3 to 5 branch sections that do have staining on the sapwood. Once you have found those, make sure to pack them properly and that those branches are always in contact with your eyes or ice bags. A good suggestion is to have a sandwich where the eyes or ice bags are the bread and the branches are the meat and the cheese. Then deliver directly to the clinic or mail it overnight.